Good morning. I am watching a video called Einstein Field Equations for Beginners. I started watching it yesterday. Looks like I got about 49 minutes into it yesterday. So my feeling is there should be two alternative descriptions to everything in the description of general relativity. I want to understand Einstein notation through matrix notation. For instance, here we have a scalar differential in Einstein notation, or nearly. If you drop the summation sign, it would be Einstein notation. The Einstein notation formation doesn't seem very expressive to me. Perhaps it should be, though. If I were familiar with the notation, wouldn't this partial derivative part clearly be a gradient? And this derivative part, wouldn't that clearly be a differential path element? But here's a way I prefer to see it, with the gradient specifically spelled out with a knobla notation, and the differential path element clearly spelled out with a vector symbol. While I'm thinking about it, I'd like to explore the dot product and its matrix multiplication counterpart. This is kind of a random seeming aside, but it just occurred to me that a transpose did the trick. And there is a trick of the transpose. Here it is in detail. If you want to take the transpose of a matrix product, such as A dot B, it isn't enough just to transpose each of the two matrices. You also have to reverse the order of the multiplication. Here you see A, B, C, D, and 1, 2 gives A plus 2B and C plus 2D, while transposing 1, 2 to 1, 2, ABCD to ACBD gives the transpose of the product A plus 2B and C plus 2D. I say it as an aside right now, but this is something that I was stuck on yesterday. Now here's another formula that he introduced at like about half an hour into the video. And my alternative expression right here. Here you see the gradient in the y coordinate system. I think I see a typo. This y1 here is supposed to be a yn. So this is the gradient on the right hand of the right hand side of the equation, and you can also see over here the gradient in the x-coordinate system. Now you can also see I've got this term, and I'm taking to calling it the Jacobian. So here above is the expression in the summed Einstein notation, and below I have four different representations in vector and matrix notation. I'm just going to move it over. You can see this is the horizontal representation and the vertical representation. And in the horizontal representation, the vector is represented as a horizontal matrix, and in the vertical representation, the vector is represented as a vertical matrix. But you can see these two things are just transposes of each other, and that's where my little aside came in a little bit earlier, because this is a product of these two matrices, and if I just transpose those two matrices and reverse the order, then you get the same thing. And what I've done over here is I've said the gradient of phi in the y-coordinate system, horizontal representation of the matrix, is equal to the gradient of phi in the x-coordinates with the horizontal matrix representation times this thing, which is the Jacobian, but the x variables are enumerated downward, x1, x2, and the y variables are enumerated across, y1, y2. And same thing down here, except this time the x variables are enumerated across 1, 2, and the y variables are enumerated down 1, 2, 1, 2. Now I think the convenient thing about remembering one of these forms, either or both, because they're just, if you'd remember that rule about doing the transposing, you can stick instead of x1, x2, x3 in here, you can put in x, y, z, and r, theta, phi, or whatever variables you want, and then just kind of follow that pattern to generate the whole matrix. Alright, I'm going to leave it for now. I have some other things I'm going to think about today, so ta-ta for now.